Hi, good afternoon to you and the viewers. See, let's start with Axis Bank first. I think Axis Bank has shown very high volatility. So the investor should be aware that this stock, even if it's from the large cap space, is highly volatile. We have seen it going from 850 levels towards the low of 650 and then bouncing back to that 750. So as long as he volatility, he can hold on to the stock. Also, I would request him to increase his time horizon from not just short term on this bank, but to at least a year or more. And on the downside, the stop loss for this is going to be at 690. And we can expect eventually the stock should touch the levels of even 800. So hold on over here. Short term volatility can be witnessed, but I think if he can increase the time horizon, that should do much better. Let's go to Reliance. Reliance has shown exceptional rally since the lows formed in March 2020. From there, we can clearly see it has been one of the most outperforming stock within the large cap space. And so far, nothing has changed for Reliance. Even after forming a low around 2250, we are seeing a very sharp bounce back on the upside. So short to long-term trend remains positive for Reliance Industries. Hold on over here. Maintain a stop loss of around 2400. Expect a target of 2800 where he can possibly book out if he wants to or extend his time horizon. And there is further possibility of it going beyond that eventually over the period of 1 or 2 years. As far as metal pack is concerned, yes, there are some concerning signs that we can see in the metal space. But try to understand one thing. The dollar index has continued to falter on the downside. We are seeing positive breakouts happening across the commodity space, whether you look at metal from aluminum perspective or from steel, and all of those stocks, I think, is just consolidating. So there was a dream run in the metal stocks that we saw a few months back, and post that there has been consolidation happening. And I think post this consolidation, the trend on the upside should resume. Short-term headwinds can be there, but I think that's an opportunity to re-enter into the metal space. As far as JSW Steel is concerned, I think there is a consolidation happening, as I said, but the overall outlook remains bullish. We can expect a target of 760 on the upside for JSW Steel with a stop loss of 620, which is an important support can be maintained.
All right, Ashish, so you're recommending a three.
Yes, absolutely. See, the cement stocks have also been on a bull run, I would say. Some short-term correction we have witnessed, but I think that's a temporary phase. And eventually, the cement should pick up, given the fact that despite of economy going through so much of volatility over the past few months and a year, we have seen outperformance from these stocks. So I think the future is going to be bright. So the two stocks from the large cap space that I'm looking at is UltraTech Cement and ACC. Both are well placed. There has been a very good recovery from the lows, especially in ACC, and we can see an impulsive rise as of now. So I think ACC can possibly move towards the level of 2600 eventually and much higher from there. So that is one of the stock you can invest into. And UltraTech also is a possible that it can go to 8400 and higher. Currently, it's quoting around 7600. So both of these stocks look good to me as of now.
All right, okay, that is the call in the cement space. I think both of
Yes,
our guests
see, if
agree
you
that.
look at Aegis Logistics, there has been a very high, heavy correction we saw from 370 to that 200 levels, and now it's bouncing back. So I would suggest he can hold on to Aegis Logistics, but I'm not sure if he should expect a very strong move on the upside. Given such a sharp correction that we have seen, the volatility is going to be heavy. But hold on for now, maintaining a stop loss of 210 for the target of 240. The next talk is DCM Shriram. I think it's just consolidating and about to give breakout. It is managing to sustain above its 20 days average, found support there, and should do much better. So DCM Shriram, hold on, maintain a stop loss of 950. We can see the levels of 1120 or much higher on the upside. And for Ipca, he has done fantastically holding on to the stock from such lower levels, and he has got tremendous return. I think the pharma space has been under pain for quite some time. It has been some time we have seen this space to revive. And once the cycle turns back on the upside, I think Ipca Lab should do much better from here on as well. So hold on to Ipca Lab. The stop loss can be 1000 and expect a target of 1200. This is for short term, but if he is holding for long term, I think Ipca Lab can even show the levels of 1500 again. Yes, absolutely. Because looking at the Tata Motors, I think in October of 2021, we saw the stock moving from the lows of around 300 towards that 500 mark in just few days of time. That was an impulsive rise in a third wave. And post that, it's obvious after such a huge run-up in just short span of time, we will see some consolidation happening. And this consolidation, I think, is an opportunity because as far as I can see on the chart, the stock can even go to the levels of 1,000. So it's a very classic opportunity to buy Tata Motors now. Over short term, the stop loss can be 460, target can be 560. But if the time horizon is 1 year or more, I think there is multifold return that we can expect from this stock. The next is Lemon Tree. Lemon Tree, again, there has been a short-term correction, but I think it found a very good support around that 43, 42 levels from where it's just moving in a narrow range. It's the volumes are picking up. It's tending to provide support towards that 20 days average. So the chances of upside breakout is more. We can see the stock going towards the level of 58, maintain a stop loss of 46 on the downside.
Okay, thanks.